Even if you're creating an email merge, it has to be done in Word. I have my document. I'll change to the Mailings tab. Click Start Mail Merge. I'm going to choose Email Messages. It starts to look a little different. This is how it might look if you were actually editing it in Outlook. Looks like an email. I need to choose my data source. Instead of choosing from my Outlook contacts, I'm going to use an existing list. It's called Requests in Chapter 3. There's just one worksheet, so we'll use that one. And you can click Edit Recipient List just to make sure that everybody is here and we have the right list and it does contain an email address. I'll click OK. And remember, it's great practice to click Match Fields and make sure everything matches up that you're expecting. I have first name, I have last name. The other really important one here is that email address is indeed correctly matched up to my email field, as it is. Okay. Now we can start adding our merge fields. I'm going to delete Dear First Name, and now I'm going to choose Greeting Line. Now, because my email called for just a first name, I can click this pull-down list and choose the first name. And if there isn't a first name, I will leave this blank. I can flick through and get a little preview about how everything's going to look. This looks good. I'll click OK. Here's my greeting line. And now I'll do the same thing with first name. Again, this time we're going to insert a merge field and just choose the first name. Oop, I do need to take out that highlight. Go back to the Home Ribbon tab and turn this off. No color. We can preview results, we can check for errors. But before we click Finish and Merge, I do want to talk about how to do this. When we printed documents, they printed immediately. But because these are emails, we don't want an entire Word document full of emails. We need individual emails. So when we go to send these, it's instantly going to send out as many copies of emails as I am merging. That is, as many rows as there are in my data source. It's going to go into my outbox, it's going to get sent, and end up in the sent folder.